tragedy in the air, a fatal accident involving the Snowbirds, the aerobatic stunt team that's the pride of our armed forces. It happened this afternoon during an air show at the Canadian National Exhibition in Toronto. Two of the planes apparently touched wingtips in midair. As nearly 100,000 spectators watched, the jets plunged into Lake Ontario, one of them engulfed in flames. One pilot ejected safely, but another wasn't as lucky. His family was in the crowd that watched him plummet to his death. Tom Kennedy reports.
Home videos in the crowd captured the moment, the slightest imprecision in a precise sport. The wings of two jets seemed to touch, with catastrophic results.
What happened?
Oh my God, did you see that?
Yeah!
One pilot, the squadron commander, bailed out in time. The other pilot was killed when he crashed into the lake. Some witnesses believe he stayed with the jet deliberately to steer it away from the hundreds of boats.
You could tell he was trying to get into a clearing that gets so many boats and everything out there, eh, that you could tell that he was really trying to get out into a clearing.
The dead pilot is Shane Antaya, a 24-year-old captain seen here earlier this summer. Antaya was one of the best pilots in the armed forces, had to be accepted in the Snowbirds. His death came in just a few seconds. Many in the crowd of more than 100,000 couldn't believe what they'd just seen.
It wasn't until you saw the other plane flame up a bit that you realized that they'd had a collision. For me, anyways, I hadn't even realized that they had touched before.
It was on fire and the plane went in the water. And of course, it was a matter of just seconds. It was all over.
Tonight, the armed forces would not speculate on the cause of the crash.
It is common procedure in the Canadian forces when we have an accident to convene a board of inquiry. Such a board has been convened. It will be arriving later on this evening.
Today's tragedy is not a precedent. Stunt pilots who defy death do not always win. Last year in West Germany, the biggest air show crash ever. Three jets collided, then fell into the spectators, killing 70. At the Canadian exhibition in 1966, another spectacular crash that killed an American pilot. Seven other pilots have also died here over the years. The Snowbirds do have special safety measures. They fly higher than other stunt teams and further away from crowds. But as the search for the downed jet continues in Lake Ontario, it's evident the sport is still dangerous. Shane Antaya is the third Snowbird pilot to die in the team's history. Tom Kennedy, CBC News, Toronto.
Kathy Renwald, thousands of spectators at the Toronto Air Show looked on in horror this afternoon as two jets from the Canadian Snowbird team crashed into Lake Ontario. The mid-air crash of the Snowbirds was witnessed by thousands of spectators at the CNE, and tragically, the crowd included the wife and family of the pilot killed when his jet nosedived into Lake Ontario. 24-year-old Shane Antaya of Stratford crashed just 100 yards from a large spectator fleet. Eyewitnesses believe he did not pull his plane out of a nosedive because it would have crashed into the hundreds of boats gathered to watch the air show.
There's no question that this is a very tragic incident, and perhaps more than a lot of other organizations, the Snowbirds are a very tightly knit team. They're really, in the pure sense of the word, a family. And of course, when you have a tragic loss in a family, everybody tends to rally together.
The other aircraft burst into flames before it plunged into the lake. The pilot, Major Daniel Dempsey of Edmonton, managed to eject before the explosion and parachuted to safety. He was quickly picked up by a rescue boat. Dempsey, the leader of the Snowbirds, was treated for minor cuts and burns. In slow motion, it is possible to see one jet drift into the other, and a small puff of smoke is visible as they brush one another. The search continues tonight for the body of the missing pilot and the plane's wreckage. As a result of today's mid-air collision at the CNE Air Show, the Canadian Forces has canceled all future shows by the Snowbirds until further notice. Videotapes are being studied to determine the cause of the fatal crash.
The CNE Air Show watched in horror today as a pilot with the Canadian Forces Snowbirds aerobatic team plunged to his death in Lake Ontario. Kate.
The accident occurred in the middle of a complicated maneuver during which two jets collided. Here's how it happened.
It had been, as usual, a spectacular show. The crowd oohing and awing as the Snowbird team performed with flawless precision. Then, with three of the planes heading directly for the lake, two of them brushed together. Watch the plane in the center. He's the team leader. His wing will gently collide with the plane on the left of your screen. The plane on the left then moves to the center, and the pilot begins an agonizingly slow plunge to his death. The team leader's aircraft was also fatally damaged in the collision. He later went into a fiery tailspin. But the pilot managed to eject safely just before the plane crashed into the lake.
The dead pilot tonight was identified as 24-year-old Captain Shane Antea of Stratford, who was flying inner right wing in the formation today. In other developments, military officials announced tonight that all performances by surviving members of the Snowbirds have been suspended indefinitely. At the same time, the decision to continue the air show after the tragic crash has been defended. As they search for wreckage tonight, Metro Police say it's a miracle more people weren't killed. A dozen Metro Police Marine units rushed to the crash site seconds after the impact in the lake. Police divers searched frantically for some trace of the missing pilot, even though Canadian Armed Forces officials said it was unlikely there would be a survivor. 24-year-old Captain Shane Antea of Stratford is missing and presumed dead. Antea was flying with the team for his second year and had logged over 1,800 flying hours without a mishap. Military officials confirmed that the victim's wife, mother, and other family members had traveled to Toronto for the air show today and watched in horror as the jets collided and plunged into the water. The families of other members of the Snowbirds team were also in the audience and had to be escorted by police to a downtown hotel in a state of shock and disbelief. Major Dan Dempsey survived the accident, parachuting to safety. Major Dempsey was rushed to Toronto General Hospital, treated for minor scrapes and burns, and released. Tonight, he was with other members of the flying team in a Toronto hotel and is described as being distraught over today's events. Police and search crews recovered debris from the plane, which was taken to the Metro Police Marine Unit as evidence to be presented in a special military crash inquiry, which will investigate what happened.
The National Defense people got a helicopter out there with sonar equipment, and we think we know where the second wreckage is, although it hasn't been located. The one where the pilot is missing, we have a buoy attached to that aircraft right now.
Earlier today, a skull and other human remains were recovered near the crash site along the waterfront. About an hour after the crash, today's edition of the air show continued. Tonight, Bill McVean, chairman of the air show, defended the decision, denying it was in bad taste.
It's tradition in the aviation business and tradition in the air show business, and it's the wish of all the people who have performed in air shows, as I have, that the show must go on. If I had been the pilot who went down in the water, it would not seem callous to me.
Today's was only the third fatal accident for the Snowbirds in 980 performances before 60 million people since 1971. Colonel Claude Thibault says Captain Antea will be missed.
The Snowbirds are a very tightly knit team. They're really, in the pure sense of the word, a family. And of course, when you have a tragic loss in a family, everybody tends to rally together. So the Snowbirds, of course, are felt with a sense of loss. But being a strong family, they'll pull together and I'm sure they'll weather out the next couple of days.
Some witnesses to today's crash speculated that Captain Antea actually gave his life when he realized his plane might slam into scores of pleasure boats in the harbor with an even greater loss of life. Colonel Thibault says public safety is always the number one priority with the Snowbirds.
Never is the crowd in jeopardy, and today illustrated that point again.
The CNE air show is still considered safe by police and the military because it's performed over water. The air show will go ahead as planned tomorrow without the Snowbirds, who will all be involved in the inquiry to determine what went wrong with what should have been a routine maneuver today.
Our coverage of today's catastrophe at the CNE would not have been possible were it not for the invention of the home video camera. Today's crash was captured on video by CFTO cameraman Greg Lockwood and dozens, perhaps hundreds, of amateur photographers. Here's how some of them saw it.
These pictures were shot from shore by Dan Wegner of Mississauga. Jim and Claudia Cernick of Cleveland were holidaying in Toronto and brought their video camera with them to today's air show. Myron McKee of Toronto took these pictures from a yacht on the lake.
Shot it. Oh no. Oh no.